Hello, Collective, and welcome back to my channel, Lumamoon Tarot. So everybody, I'm back with you to do another Collective love reading, right? This reading is for the Collective, so it may not resonate with all of you. Just take what resonates and leave the rest. And you can be any sign for Collective readings. If something drew you into the title, there's something in it for you, okay? And thank you everyone for your likes, subscribes, comments, shares, donations, everything that you guys do that have helped this channel keep growing down through the years. Man, I appreciate all of you so much. I hope you know that. And I hope you guys are having a great Saturday. I keep forgetting it's the weekend. All right, so I am hearing a song, but I don't know who does it because it just popped into my head. I'm the man in the box, swimming in my ish, right? Won't you come and save me? Save me. Yeah. Deny your maker. Yeah, this person, I feel like there's a masculine energy who is stuck now in a toxic cycle. I feel like they chose this and now they're like swimming in it, okay? Rubbing their nose in it, okay? the divine is rubbing their nose in it. And because you know what? They denied the messages that they got from the divine. This person has had ample time to make things right with you. I feel like they made a choice to settle in a toxic situation. I feel like they were stubborn, okay? They challenged the divine. So the divine is rubbing their nose in their own crap. And I don't know who does that song, guys. Can somebody please drop a comment? Because seriously, when I get these songs like popping into my head in a reading, I don't have time to look it up, you know? So if you can drop a comment, if you know who does that song and the name of the song, it's got to be Man in the Box, I think, or something. But this person is stuck, all right? And I'm being led to use my mythology deck. It's a handmade deck. I'm not going to take reversals out of it. All right, so Divine, what can you show me for the Collective? Yeah, this person's really burdened. Yeah, they're burdened, they're stuck, okay? If you look really close at this card, if this person moves even an inch, this boulder is going to crush them. You know, if they back away, it's going to push them off the cliff. If they move to one side, it's going to take out a shoulder and an ankle. If they move to the other side, it's going to crush their head. This person can't move. They're stuck in this position, carrying this massive burden on their shoulders, okay? I feel like they're with a karmic individual because it is, they're stuck in a karmic situation, right? They're having their nose dug in it, okay? But this person, they don't want to have anything to do with this karmic. No matter what this karmic does, this masculine energy just, they don't want to have anything to do with it, okay? Nothing. They don't want to have anything to do with this person. The karmic can't get their attention. They can't make them love them. This the person that they're with is just miserable sitting here, but yet, if you look at this really close, they slept on the messages that they got from the divine, and they were very, they challenged the divine. Okay, it's almost like this person thought they were bigger than God. And they could make, you know, they could make whatever choice they want and have no consequences for it. All right, now this person's got free will. They've got free will to choose whatever they want, but there's always a price. You know, the universe demands balance. Okay, so you get what you pay for when it comes to the universe. And you pay for what you get, right? And this person, they thought they could control the outcome. They were being stubborn. Just like a rock, you know? And here you on the bottom of the deck, you're the divine feminine. This is all this person is thinking about. Look at you. You're getting like fanned by the universe, right? Bathing in all of this beauty. You could be a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, but not necessarily. This person here could possibly, I'm feeling Taurus energy off of this, but it doesn't have to be, right? So, yeah, I feel like they really bucked the divine. They bucked the system. They thought that they could do what they wanted and have no consequences. I feel like they're talking to a friend right now. And I feel like they're getting good advice. They're kind of bearing it all. They're talking to a friend like, I'm really stuck swimming in my own crap. I don't know what to do. And I feel like their friend is telling them, well, you're going to have to wrestle this snake. You know, maybe the friend is telling them you're kind of stuck with this snake. That's this karmic. Or they're telling them to, you know, and here, look at this. Hercules killed a mistake. Yep, they were sitting on this. It says was sitting and pushed from a mountain. I'm telling you, they were sitting on this, and the divine is like, go. You can stay in this now. Now you're stuck in this box. Now you're the man in the box, having your nose ground in all of it. Okay, by the divine. Yeah, this person was a player. I feel like they played you, divine feminine. In and out energy, you know, thought that they would have no consequences. This is somebody who maybe made some kind of impulsive move, okay? And they played you. They could have used you and just abandoned you. They abandoned and used a divine feminine and chose a karmic. And now, and you know what? The divine sent them messages to make things right. Write this or you're going to be stuck. And now this person is stuck, having to shoulder this burden. All right, give me one more, and then we're going to hop into the tarot, okay? Yeah, they may even have a baby. They may have gotten somebody pregnant here. There could be children involved. Yeah, look on the bottom here of the deck, too. I feel like this person is stuck, and look at the look on their face like, oh, crap, there was a price to pay for this. Yeah, they're very surprised now. Now they're like, now what do I do? Talking to a friend, trying to get advice. What do I do now? And I feel like with both of these cards out together here, their friend is telling them that they're stuck, especially if they have children, if they got somebody pregnant with it. There's that wand. They won't let go of control. You know what I mean? They have to try to control the situation. Or they're carrying this wand because they want a new beginning someplace else. I feel like it's both. Yeah, heartache. And you know what? This arrow is being pulled out of this heart and being shot directly at this person. They're going to start experiencing this pain. All right, what else can you show me about the man in the box? Magician energy, you could be dealing with a Virgo, Aries. Yeah, this person manipulated you, and so they're getting their tower. I feel like you're the high priestess here. Divine feminine energy right here. Cancer, Pisces, Gemini energy here off of the high priestess. Yeah, this person manipulated you, thought they could treat people however they wanted. Possibly didn't even realize you were a divine feminine, and now the divine is like, sorry, there was some kind of glitch in the camera. I really do hope that it all recorded here. I'm just going to backtrack a little bit, okay? They're getting heartbreak sent to them because it's coming back on them. Because they manipulated a high priestess, earth angel energy, right? Divine feminine energy. And now the divine is like, you know what? You're going to deny your maker? Right? That's what the song says. Deny your maker. You're gonna deny your maker and think that whatever you do is not gonna have any consequences. Well, here's the consequences. Okay? And I feel like, won't you come and save me? They're asking a friend for advice. Please help, dude. I'm stuck. My life is crap right now. Yeah, look. Again, on the bottom of the deck, the Four of Pentacles. This person feels stuck wherever they are, and it's because they are. They denied their maker. They denied the messages that spirit was sending them. And it was all because of ego now. This is the man in the box. It was all because of ego. They thought that they could challenge spirit. That this is what happens when you challenge God. God strikes you down. Now they're in a lot of regret. They're looking at themselves and they don't even know who they are anymore. You know, I see no reflection in this mirror. Okay, none. And I feel like they know they chose something that didn't have any love in it. They had a blessing in love there right in front of them and they threw it to the curb, right? And they turn their back on their divine feminine. And now this person, they just kind of hover in their life. They have to sit in this. Okay? They're having their nose ground into their own crap by the divine. They disregarded everything and thought that they didn't, you know, have to do the right thing. Yeah, you've got star energy. I feel like you're in a time of celebration right now. You're really out here having a glow up, really is what this is. You're an empath, a healer, a spiritual teacher, but I feel like you've just paid attention and really focused on helping other people during this time of separation, okay? And I feel like now you've got a huge following. People are absolutely loving whatever you're putting out there. They're loving it because you're doing it with love. Okay? So when you work in your passion and you love what you do, other people love what you do. And you're a guide for other people now on this journey because of all of this. You're ending a cycle and starting a new one here, and this is bringing in a time of celebration for you. And your person, that it's almost like they're walking a tightrope. You know, usually I would say that this is opinions of others, you know, and it might be, but I feel like they're gonna fall in their own crap here. I mean, this isn't even a tightrope. This person, yeah, they wanted to have control. There's that wand again. And the divine is like, okay, well, you're on shaky ground. And so, you know, here's what you get. This person's about to fall. And they can see it coming. Like now they know. Now they know they're gonna fall right on top of all of the things that they've done, all the burdens that they've done. Yep, painful ending here. And you know what? Here comes even more karma. I feel like this person's gonna lose money. They could lose a job. They could lose their health. Okay, they're ringing a bell. Like this is very alarming, right? I need help. That's what they're saying here. They followed the wrong person straight out into a really horrible situation for themselves and kept themselves there and decided that they were not going to be challenged, right? That ego. It's the ego that really got them here. And now they're stuck wherever they are, you know? And here's this person is holding up two fingers like, peace, you know? Like, yeah, I'm all good. They could be pretending out there that everything is fine when it's not. I feel like this is going to cost them. It's going to hurt them in their finances because I'm seeing these pentacles on the ground. This person's going to pay, I think, in all areas of their life because the universe You know, you have to pay for your decisions. It comes with a price. That ego, it came with a price. Their decisions came with a price. And they're paying the price now, collective. Justice. Karmic justice. What did I say? The scales must be balanced. This is the universe saying there's a price to be paid. There's a price to be paid for how they acted, how they treated you. Seven of Cups. I feel like this is for you. You're going to have a lot of, yeah, this is for the Empress. Thank you. You're going to have a lot of new options coming towards you here. Okay, and one of these options is going to lead to the Ten of Pentacles, a commitment. I feel like right now you're in this energy where you're working hard, doing a job for the divine, right? Leading other people into their healing from this journey. And it's made you very abundant. You're actually about to live a very comfortable life. I will say that for whoever this is resonating with, yeah. You've leveled up here at least three times, three major accomplishments. You could even have like three forms of income. And you're going to be very abundant, extremely abundant. And I feel like all this person from your past, all they can do is watch you. And here's the divine, even for their convenience, the divine nailed an arrow, right? So that they know what direction to look. Okay, and they're looking straight at you. The Empress, the one from the past that they wronged. The one who they may have thought that you really didn't have much to bring to the table, but they were wrong about that. You're probably, it would take four queens to equal one of you, okay? You're every queen in the deck. And this person, all they can do is remain stuck, still holding that wand, remain stuck, they're just watching you. They're watching you, okay? I feel like this person needs to drop some kind of control. Yeah, well, yeah, you're their twin flame, and now they're feeling like a fool. They were warned. They were warned, you got to watch where you're going on this. You know, watch your decisions. Be very careful. It's going to come with a price. You're going to walk right off of that cliff. And that's pretty much what they did. And now all they can do is watch you. I feel like there is somebody who's in the middle of this connection. And I feel like it's this clingy karmic. But this is who they chose. This is who they chose. So, yeah, this person is stuck wherever they are in the box that they chose, swimming in their own bad decisions, right? You got to listen to the song, guys. Swimming in their own crap. And you're the Queen of Pentacles. They can see this now. You're sitting on a very abundant and stable throne, okay? And the Queen of Pentacles is wifey energy. So this person knows that you're actually the one for them, but now they're stuck. They can't make a move. This is what they decided. And this is what the universe let them have. They let them have it. I'm telling you, the universe is letting this person have it. Oh, yeah. And they're suffering. Everything is kind of dwindling away from this person. They can't walk this tightrope much longer. Tower moments. Ten of Swords to the back. Yeah. I feel like they want you to reach out to them. Won't you come and save me? Nope. You're not saving this person because you know what? They didn't do anything to help you when this person broke your heart, put you in a third party, turned their back on you, and challenged God. So no, you're not, you're being told not to approach this person first. They needed to come towards you and make this right. They had plenty of time to do it and plenty of messages. And they didn't do it because they were challenging God. I feel like now this person is kind of feverishly working maybe to build up their pentacles, but they don't look real happy about it. And I feel like they're watching you move forward and being sitting on this beautiful 10 of pentacles. You've got 11 pentacles here and an empress, right? And a star. You're everything, and your wifey material for this person. They want to come back to you, but the more they watch, the angrier they get. Because this person, they now they're paying a price for their decisions. I don't know how else to describe it. They're getting their karma. They're getting their karma for this. They're having their nose dug in their own ish. Turning Tides Tarot, I love her. I don't know her name, but I love you, Turning Tides. She says ish all the time, and I think it's fabulous because, you know, a lot of us don't want to cuss out here, you know. But that's what this is. Knight of Pentacles energy. I feel like, honestly, I feel like you're getting somebody new here. Hierophant. You're being blessed. You're being blessed with a new connection here coming in. It's been coming in slowly, but honestly, I'm seeing this horse on a trot. So I feel like this person is coming in quicker than you think. And this is going to be somebody who's going to want to get to know you slowly. Okay? They're going to want to approach this Empress, and yeah, they're going to want to get to know you. And this is being brought in by the Hierophant. So yeah, you're about to be blessed, and all this person can do is stand here and watch. They're being made to stand. You will stand here and be stuck and look in this direction. Okay? Yep. Ace of Wands. I'm just seeing someone feverishly wanting to come in with a new beginning. Still holding on to that wand. Right? Yeah, you're having this new beginning here. I feel like your person's getting angrier and angrier. Yeah, they may be waiting for you to contact them, and you're not going to contact them. They could be waiting for money or some kind of opportunity to come in. This is somebody who may even need to travel a distance to get to you, that kind of thing. But I'm telling you, with all of this snow, there's no green grass under here. Nowhere in this picture is a single blade of grass. This person's not getting their ships aren't coming in, and they're not getting any new opportunities. So you know what? I feel like you're not going to be contacting this person. I feel like you're moving forward. And once again, there's that Four of Pentacles. Oh no, right? This person doesn't want you to move forward. They want to try to hang on, but they're stuck where they are because of the juggling, because they challenged God. You know, that's the choice that they made. They're stuck. And all they can do is watch you move on with somebody else and be blessed. Ace of Pentacles, they don't have any money coming in, but you do. But you do, collective. Yeah, death. Look, because all they did was hang out in a situation they didn't really want, right? While they knew what they were supposed to be doing, they got the messages here. See how they're illuminated? But they're stuck now. And now they have to have it out with the divine. They've got to talk to God about this. If they want to be unstuck, they've got to talk to God, because I feel like things are ending for this person because of the juggling the person that they wanted, right? Juggling the one they can't forget, not wanting to let you go, being smug, right? That's this person being smug about it, maybe wanting you to chase after them, but no, you were too strong for this person. You had boundaries. You have boundaries, man. If somebody wrongs you, you know your worth. And no, I feel like this person tried to overstep your boundaries, wanted you to chase after them, come towards them, thought they could be smug, thought they could challenge the divine. And no, you've got your boundaries up with this person. They're not going to hear from you. Won't you come and save me? No, you're not saving them. They're going to have to carry their own burdens on this one. This is their own crap that they're in. They created this. They have to deal with this. Okay? Wanting to regain control, right? It's a swords card, and this person still wants control over the situation. They're still holding on to that wand. You know, this can be, most readers will say this is going to calmer waters. Yeah. But in this card, I'm seeing that they still want control over the situation. They want to put you back in this boat. Have you face all of these burdens and the pain from the past. They just want to regain control of their life. I don't feel like you're going to help them with that. No, they're having their nose ground into their own ish, right? Thank you, Turning Tides Tarot. I love the way she says it. So, and I love her. She's a fabulous reader, guys. Check her out. But yeah, Five of Swords. This is what this person gets. It's coming right back on them. See, if you look really close at this picture, I feel like this is the divine saying, number one, pal, I'm a whole lot bigger than you, okay? I'm way bigger than you. Number two, you sent my divine feminine away crying, and you did nothing. Now the divine is stepping in saying, see this sword? This is the one you put in the divine feminine's back. I'm giving it back to you. They're actually telling this person this. You're going to get all these swords from all of this, you know, the Five of Swords. It's sabotage. It's backstabbing. It's lies behind your back. It's, I feel like they betrayed themselves when they betrayed you. And the divine is handing them each sword at a time. Take this sword. This is what you get for what you did there. Take this sword. This is what you get for what you said. Okay, this is the divine giving back to them all that they dished out. Yep, and they're stuck. And here, yep, because you're an earth angel. You're an earth angel. You're here to spread joy, inspiration to other people. You know, help them heal from their spiritual journey here. Yeah, you're an earth angel. They screwed with an earth angel, so the divine is stepping in. Yep. It's this man in the box. And no one's coming to save them. Mm-mm. Because they denied their maker, and they denied the messages that they were getting from the divine. All out of ego. All out of ego. They thought they were bigger than the divine, and the divine is showing them, no, oh no, no. I'm the biggest one. Yep, the devil. I feel like this person's stuck. They're stuck in their own mess. Crap, right? They're chained now to the devil. This is who they chose. I'm going to give you all these swords right back to you, says God. Yep. And look at this picture. You're here on top of the wheel, right? Speaking your truth. This is telling the truth. Being honest. You've got a mic here. I feel like you could even be in the public eye. Maybe a public speaker. Possibly even another tarot card reader out here on YouTube. You could be doing something like that, right? whatever it is you're doing, you've been honest through this whole thing because you had integrity. And the universe looks kind of ticked off to me, right? They're upset. They're like, you don't get to do this, right? You don't get to challenge the divine in the universe. So they've got your person by the foot. They've got this snake that they're with by the tail, and I feel like they're keeping them stuck. The universe is not playing around. Spirit is not playing a game with this person. They were playing a game. They thought that they could control everything. No, no, they're not in control. The divine is. So this person is being taught a lesson. It's the end of the cycle. This door is closing on this person. And I feel like they really are stuck. They're the man in the box having their nose dug in it, okay, by the universe. I can't make it up. And you, Earth Angel, all right, divine feminine energy, you're moving forward here. I feel like you're manifesting a new soulmate connection, and that's coming in here with that Page of Pentacles, right? Someone who's going to really, they're interested in you. They're going to be interested in you and everything about you. It's going to be somebody who's going to want to get to know you slowly. And I feel like it's being sent to you by the divine. So get ready for the new, because you're getting blessed here. New beginnings for you as you move forward. You could be an Aquarius, Cancer, Sagittarius. I've got Taurus, Aries out here as well. Your person, they could be any sign. A lot of fire out here. So Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. We've got Scorpio, Capricorn. Could be any sign, really. Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. Anyway, yeah, that's what I've got for this reading. I hope this helps. I hope it resonates with you guys. If you like this video, please click that like button, right? Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and you love this vibe. And until next time, everyone, take care of you and peace out.